So hey guys, Jonathan Graham here for Guitar Interactive Magazine, and we are at Dean HQ here with Chris. How are you doing today, buddy?
Good, man. How are you doing?
I'm feeling fantastic to be here in Florida. This is a little NAMM, I don't even know, it's a little NAMM, just private NAMM, isn't
right,
it here?
It's our little private trade show.
Yeah.
And one of the things that we like to do is that we have a facility that's different from a lot of places. Now we can have the room and just say, you know what, screw it, let's do it ourselves. Let's make it for us and our closest friends to come down and celebrate the new stuff together.
Yeah.
And with the new focus of the company, it's just exciting, man.
Yeah.
You know, it's exciting, and to be able to do it on our own. And like, we've always been a very rogue brand, mm-hmm. but now we're even more like, you know what, screw it, we're gonna do what we want, we're gonna make it here and make it a party for everybody.
Well, you know, it definitely feels that way. And of course, for the guys watching, you saw Nick Jensen's fantastic review of the Select series, and that got our appetite wet. We wanted to come and see, you know,
so
what was
awesome,
what was
man.
happening. So there's a whole load more right here. I'm dumbfounded. Where are we going to start with these?
Well, first, I just want to show a little bit of history. Just to show up here, this is where it really all began. Right up here, we have the original patents pending V and ML, and then an original 1980 Cadillac. Obviously, they're not for sale, but they're a part of our... We have so much of the original product still here in the building, and that's how, when we design stuff, we have the actual stuff to measure it against. And we don't have to go, well, what did we do back then? You know, we have to go find other, you know, collectors and borrow their stuff. No, we have it.
Yeah.
We kept it. Evan and his late father, Elliot, were very smart about, you know, keeping a good portion of some of this old stuff around for the sake of reference.
Yeah.
And we always know, because now we're like, this, we use this really as our ground zero.
Mm.
Now we can do it even better than then, but we still want to keep that tradition alive of doing it the right way with the right measurements. But some of our practices are way better now.
Right, interesting. You know? Now, of course, with you guys as well, everyone in the building pretty much is a player. So
yeah.
That plays a big part in this as well, isn't it?
It sure does, man. Everybody around here is a player. Whether, you know, you play in, you know, big festivals, or whether you're playing clubs, or whether you, you know, you've toured, whatever it happens to be, even folk musicians and whatever it happens, we all are really focused on what the player wants, because we're all players. And we kind of treat ourselves like a rogue gang, almost like a biker gang. They used to joke, like Evan used to say, it's like the mob, all right? It's hard to get in, and it's even harder to get out. So, and we take care of each other's backs at all time. We're not fighting and butting heads. We're like, hey man, I can't quite get this idea together. And you go to another guy, even if he's not in your department.
Yeah.
I mean, there's guys on our setup line that are touring. One of the guys in the setup line, Jesse, he opened up for me in our last U.S. tour.
Sure.
And always bouncing ideas. And just phenomenal players everywhere. And it just creates that unity that we're here to make guitars. We're not here to make widgets.
Yeah.
All right?
I mean, yeah.
And we're not here to, you know, to try to get the most hooks in the world, to try to be the cheapest. I think our genuine attitude of why we're doing this is what's really quickly separating us apart from the rest of the packs, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, well, there's definitely space to do it, and there's been a lot of buzz over the last 12 months, last 2 years, in fact,
mm-hmm.
you know, with the Select series and everything else that's coming out. Now, for the guys watching, they may be a little bit like they're familiar with Dean historically. We've already seen there's some stuff from the past. Where is Dean right now in terms of, like, the, you know, where's the entry level, and like, where, what
That's
was
really
it was
great.
A good place to start?
Let's make this very easy. That was part of the rebranding, and the I guess the mental change of the company was that outside of USA, which is our pinnacle, handmade, Dan Russell built, Pat Baker finishing it up. That's the pinnacle tier,
yeah.
USA custom shop. But everything else, let's make it easy. Good, better, best. X series, that's your entry level. Classic series, the classic series is basically what we've always been known for, with the 79s and things like that we've had for a long time at that price point.
Sure.
But then we did Select series, and the point of that was to say there was such a gap between USA and classic series,
sure. Yeah.
That you had a lot of guys that were pros, pro musicians that were touring a lot, that we didn't have that for them. And we didn't have that high-end import that said high quality, reliability, everything you can want, but at a reasonable price.
Yeah.
And I'm not saying the USAs aren't reasonable. I'm just saying a little bit more obtainable.
Yeah. It's more of a, you know... sometimes that could be your like, I'm already distracted by this one right here, because it's like your dream guitar, you know, sort of thing. But
this one is amazing, yeah. Because this one and this one,
it's a really weird story, but in our batch of mahogany that we got in for the USAs, Dan found these two pieces of strange figured mahogany, yes, out of the batch.
Incredible looking.
All we did was sand it and gloss it. We didn't pre-stain anything. This is the natural color of the wood.
And we're like, we gotta make, you know, based on
the Select Series MDs, there's a custom version of it, and of course the classic D with the pickguard.
Absolutely. And it's just been,
we do that kind of stuff around here. You know, Dan will find something. Hey man, check out this. Ooh, we gotta build something out of that. That's cool. And just, who cares? Just try it.
Of course.
Give it a whirl.
And of course, you guys, you're very well known for your fantastic custom artwork as well.
Yeah.
So what's changed here? Do you know who's working on these?
This all comes from basically our main painter, Fausto. Mm. It's his airbrush guy. He's doing all these, and we just kind of let him do whatever he wants.
Yeah.
And we're doing even more and more in this stuff over the next year. You're gonna be seeing some pretty cool stuff coming from some really big badass painters.
Awesome. Okay. Very, very nice.
I don't want to give away too much, but let's just say we're not complacent of where we are.
Yeah.
When I came on board, Eric and I decided to change things out with the team, of course.
Yeah.
And we're not doing just like, what can we do now? It's about a 3 and a 5 year plan, and we're constantly working on a 3 and a 5 year from today.
Sure. Now, for the guys watching, I mean, we're obviously international. The guys can watch it anywhere, but, you know, we are a UK brand. The guys in the UK, they want to make sure they can get their hands on some of these.
Yep.
So is this going to be available for the guys in the UK?
Yes, it is. We're working on some stuff right now that is going to ensure, I can't say too much, it's not my place to, but that's going to ensure that the UK has full Dean and Luna accessibility.
Fantastic, right.
So that's something we've known too. I'm gonna be honest, overseas, you know, as we always say, across the big ponds, we know that it's been tough to get a hold of a lot of our stuff, and we're making sure that doesn't happen anymore.
That's fantastic news. And I know for somebody like yourself who does tour around the world, you know, it's important for you too. You want to be able to go into a store and then maybe get one for the show in that evening,
right.
You know what I mean? So.
Well, we all know how the airlines can be.
Yeah.
Okay, and they're not always the most gracious people with your beautiful instruments. So when you get over to another country and you see that your case has been destroyed and you're asking them for help and all they're giving you is a middle finger, you got to find some place to go get something that you love. And as a person that's been through that, it's a stressful situation, and we can't have that anymore.
No.
We got to be able to go into some place that you trust, that you learn, that you grow with, that's local, that, you know, is a real believer of the gear, and that treats their customers great, that you can walk in and say, hey, I'm here, can you help me out?
Yeah.
And know that it's available.
Definitely. And for you guys watching, we'll get all the information on where you're going to be able to get your hands on these as soon as it becomes available. But until then, let's look at some more stuff from the line. So you walk us through it.
Like you can see, these are all USAs. These are all customs. Like I said, we showed you the historic pieces of where it all came from. Custom versions of the MD.
Yeah.
We all know these are higher priced guitars, but it really is just a show of how much attention to detail that Dan and his guys and Pat and his guys do to make these things great. I almost wish I had a picture of the inside of the wiring of these things.
Really?
Because Andy, in the wiring area of USA, he's developed his own style of wiring that has become almost viral on the internet. Like, how does this guy do this? It almost looks like there's nothing in there, and it's like the most clean and beautiful thing that I've ever seen. It's an art in itself.
I haven't seen that,
Yes. As a matter of fact, when we get done, I'll have to take you over there, and I'm going to say, Andy,
I don't even need to watch a video. He's right there.
So as we talked about, here's the Select Series.
Yeah.
We're not done yet. You know, we have new stuff. We have the icons now in Select Series, and we're going to be expanding these now into not only more colors or whatever, but we're going to be putting out a few more options. We're going to be expanding the 7-string stuff a little bit up, adding more Floyds, 24 frets. That's going to be coming soon. But as you know, with the Select Series, we have all the proprietary Seymour Duncans with the matte finish and the sandblasted pole pieces.
Yep.
We're using all the best components we can that's available to us to make these things great. And also, really keeping a hold of what Dean is all about, but keeping it as professional and tight and just strong as possible for the consumer. Whether it be a musician playing in a club, whether he's playing at a festival, whether you're touring the States or, you know, the UK.
Yeah.
No matter what it is, we have to make sure it's available.
So are we looking at ebony boards throughout the entire range?
Everything is ebony.
And like with the fret wire and stuff, is there any room for any customization there? Or is it
on the Select series, not really a customized thing because they are factory built. But we are in the works of trying to offer a few more things without pushing it over the top to where it breaks the bank for the end user.
Yeah.
But we are looking at some different fret options that we're going to be utilizing.
Because that's the thing, it's a fantastic feeling neck. You know, the jumbo frets are, you know, it's a joy to play, but not everyone's into that, are they?
Right.
You know what I mean? So,
exactly. Yeah. But that's also why we use the satin necks. Yeah. You know, the back of the necks are all satin, but we try to keep it aesthetically pleasing so where you don't have that white look, you know,
sure,
in the middle.
Yeah.
So we made sure that the necks were stained the same color as the wood all the way around, so it has the aesthetic of being nice, smooth, and consistent, but you still have that feel of a nice satin neck to where your endurance, if you're sweating and you're just being disgusting like me on stage or whatever it happens to be, that you still, you're not getting stuck.
It's really comfortable.
And this is where we've also expanded into it. We've all seen the Nash Vegases in the past, but one thing that I had a problem with personally, and I just didn't think that the Nash Vegases that we had were Dean enough. Mm-hmm. They weren't Dean enough. They looked too traditional and not as aggressive, not as, you know, rock and roll, you know, not as metal. So changed it up, you know, put the ebony board on it, the 1000 series Floyds, moved the position of a few things, used the scarab style headstock that we use. We're actually changing the logos on these eventually.
Okay.
And we'll show you that logo here in a minute. But, you know, with the proprietary Duncans, we're just really making it more of a Dean Select series and less of just a traditional shape.
Sure. No, they look fantastic. Look like something John 5 would be tempted by, that's for sure.
Yeah, there you go. And a great old friend, too. Wonderful guy. This is something that was a big jump for us. So we wanted to make some guitars that were not in the Dean comfort zone. And in the world that we've all played in around here, there's a lot of different styles of players. A lot of guys like to use 7 strings. A lot of guys like to utilize different tunings with a lot of options. So we decided to go with this Exile, which is a thinner, more streamlined shaped guitar. These are also proprietary pickups from EMG, the 5766 TWs in brushed chrome, to where each pickup is splittable. So you can go into single coil mode. So that way, no matter what style of music, if you want to get more of that classic single coil sound, you have that availability. If you want to get more of the humbucker, you can make a combination. And then having 7 strings, as well as the 6 string models, with a thinner, flatter neck, 16 inch radius, not the normal 12.
Oh, interesting, okay.
So really geared up for the high-speed exotic players.
And I'm noticing that price point.
Yeah.
I mean, that is, you've done a great job there.
Thank you.
Because that looks like if you were just to look at this right now, I haven't picked one up yet, but this looks like a custom instrument.
Yeah, and that's what their main goal was to go with exotic woods. Just really top of the line everything, but because we spent so much time with our factories, and we have such a friendship with our factories now, that we were able to make some sort of agreements to reduce costs so that the end user can get them and we can be able to sell more, and just have better production. Now the MDs, you can see this is the logo that a lot of these stuff with these headstocks is going to be slowly going into.
Okay.
And one of the reasons is not that we don't love our Wing logo, we love it to death. But this is the guitar that I personally use in Deicide. And one of the experiences that I had at a few of the shows, and some of the bigger shows, was people asked me, what kind of guitar is that? I couldn't read the logo. And it's not that we don't. I mean, our Wings are our tattoo, our brand. Josh has got a tattooed on his arm.
Yeah.
We love it. But we want people to be able to see what it is from a distance.
Yeah.
And, you know, we played a couple of shows, and I was like, guys, we got to make this thing a little bit more visible and kind of a little bit more classic, because with this style of a guitar, there is a certain American heritage that goes to that with the visible logo, and it's the attitude that goes along with it. So, and even this, these are all bolt-on instruments, and people ask, why didn't you do them neck through? Truth is, and I learned this from years, a bolt-on instrument sounds different.
Yeah.
It has a bigger mid-range punch. It's very wide. And for guys that are out there traveling and touring, if something happens, it's a lot easier to fix on.
Makes a lot of sense.
You know, yeah. Somebody comes up and knocks it off a stand and something happens, it's a lot easier to fix on. And I personally have fallen in love again with bolt-on instruments because bolt-on doesn't mean cheaper. And in manufacturing and in the world of, you know, guitar building in general, having that option to be able to try different things really quick has become a lot more fun again. Like when it was in the 80s, when you'd be able to try different pickups, try this, experiment. And that's what we're able to do in manufacturing.
That's cool. That's cool. And I'm really liking this choice of the logo, like you say, because the thing about it is as well is that that's a fantastic logo, but sometimes logos look different on different headstocks, don't they?
Right.
And that looks like that's just made just for this specific headstock.
Right, and that's what we're going to be using on the Nash Vegas as well.
Fantastic.
On this particular one. So now I was telling you about the different tiers. We just saw the Select Series, which are high-end imports.
Yeah.
And this is the Classic Series, the stuff that Dean's most known for making in the electric guitar world.
Yeah.
So this is where, you know, all the 79 Series kind of reside, the Colts, things that we've been making for the last, you know, 20, 30 years, but now we have a place for them to sit because this is no longer the top of the line in imports. This is our mid-tier.
Sure.
Nothing's really any different except that it's now comfortable to sit here and people know that they can live with us from cradle to grave.
Yeah.
And we have the pick guard versions here. You know, we obviously have the 79 in white. This is the stuff that we've all seen forever. They're going to stick around and we're going to have a lot of finish changes. We're going to be experimenting with more pickups soon as well. And at these price points, you know, the $599, $649 price points, which is a comfortable place to be, but not, sometimes you want to go a little farther along.
Yeah.
You know? So
makes
we love
sense.
Them. We love them. And here's what I was talking about, stage one, the X Series. We don't dabble in the $199 too much, but we do have them as kind of like the gateway drug, so to speak. Yeah. But our X Series stuff is really about $399. And we're going to be seeing even more adaptations with this, but we wanted to make a high-quality, great-playing guitar that was affordable for somebody to start off with. And the X Series, they are all bolt-on construction, but they're all better woods than what we've had in the past, and nice flame tops, and we're experimenting also with new pickups. We're rewinding our method of making the OEM DMT pickups.
Okay.
So we're trying more and more styles of it without jacking the price up.
You know, it's really impressive to see these so close. I'm getting distracted just looking at them. What I'm thinking about is we see so many of these guitars that come in at that sort of price point from your competitors, you know? And you can kind of see, that's going to be that price. Like, you get used to guitars looking a particular way. And what I'm talking about is little imperfections on the fingerboard. You know,
right.
You can see that the woods are not maybe the finest of woods.
Mm-hmm.
But this, I think I'd be fooled into thinking this was coming from the next tier up. You know,
that's,
this doesn't look in.
Yeah. That is the goal, man. We're not, like I said, we're not out to be the cheapest.
Yeah.
We're out to just offer the most that somebody can ask for in every price point.
Mm.
And we're comfortable being in our own skin, and we just want everything to look cool, man. You know, if this is your first guitar and you're playing your first local club or whatever it happens to be, whatever venue you happen to be going to, you want to feel cool about it, man. You don't want to feel like you have a beginner guitar.
No.
You want to feel like you have a great guitar that's going to hold up, and then as you have this for a while, you try new pickups, you try new this, you try new that. Next thing you know, you're trying this guitar,
you're
in a Select.
You're still figuring out what it is you like, you know, about it. Yeah, no, fantastic.
This is a great way to start. We've had, you know, a lot of cool changes, as you know, with Kerry King coming on board, and, you know, we'll have to take a walk over there and take a look at that Kerry King guitar because it has the LEDs and all this great
stuff.
You're
going to have to get him back out on the road to play them.
Well, there's a lot. Well, that's not my position to talk about, but I'm sure you're going to be hearing a lot from him soon.
Fantastic.
So that's not my place to talk about, but you're going to be hearing a lot from
him. Breaking news.
The guy's not going to bed.
Well, that's good to hear.
And, like, right here, these actually came out a little bit ago, but a lot of people haven't seen them yet, which I love Michael Amott. I mean, he's one of the greatest guys in the business, one of the best guitar players on the planet. And we know how much of a fan he is of Michael Schenker, so we kind of like to stick them together.
Sure.
You know, they're both fans of each other. But this Tin Man ended up taking off for us. We tried to figure out a way to make like a really chrome-looking guitar without making it look, well, cheesy.
Yeah. You know? It's tough to pull off, isn't it?
Yeah, and it was, but Michael's been such a good team player for us, and he's always there whenever we need him to do anything, and back and forth. You know, we have a long time love with him, and I love this guitar. The weight, the way the neck is, everything about it is just fantastic.
Awesome.
And then we tried this for Vinnie Moore, which is, you know, basically a Select Series from the Select Series factory, semi-hollow body with a strong center block, set through construction, but with all of the same attributes as his American, but affordable at $1,199. So it has the USA DMTs as well as the DiMarzio pickups, the 1000 series Floyds, and it's just howling. And I believe he's going to be playing here this weekend on the import to show everybody how much
fantastic.
He loves it.
Oh, fantastic. You're right. Kill him.
Obviously, Michael Baddio, who's been with us forever and a day. But then over the last couple of years, we had Christian Martucci from Stone Sour.
Yep.
Surprisingly enough, this has become probably our best-selling signature Model V. And it's because it's very ambiguous, it's very awesome looking, but it doesn't say, look at me, my name is this, right across it.
Sure.
It's very for everybody,
yeah.
And it looks cool. It looks kind of vintagey, but it plays fast, you know, and the neck shape is really cool. It's got it's a V-shaped neck, but it's also subtle as well.
Sure.
Carl Sanders from Nile, his previous models, which were so very unique to him with the scallop fingerboards, the zero knobs on it and all that. We wanted everybody to be able to have a Carl-style guitar, but not have it be as just for one type of customer. So now it's got the cool Egyptian Sethos graphic on it, as well as the 1000 series Floyd, two pickups now. So you have the Invader and then the Duncan Custom Ebony fingerboard. Just a really cool, fun piece to put out. And Carl, he's been playing Dean since the first day I met him, and that had to have been about, gosh, almost 20 years ago. I think way before he was ever even officially playing Dean guitars, he was always playing a Dean every time I saw him.
And why not?
Yeah. Eric Peterson, we all know him. Testament, I mean, come on. He's one of the godfathers of thrash metal. And the key songwriter of the band, too. And up there, you can see the new Z. We did the same thing, as we could see the very big Testament graphic on this Limited. The one above, we wanted to make it a little bit more for everybody.
Yeah.
EMGs, Floyd 1000, set through construction, ebony fingerboard, diamond inlays. But if you're playing that, you're not looking like, oh, that guy's playing a Signature Series guitar on
stage. Sure.
So, a really important part of the line, and it's going to be a big focus for us in the future, is our basses.
Okay.
Now, one of the things, actually the most important part about these basses is the wood combinations. These are really thick tops. Everything is all big chunks of wood put together for tonal complements. And I'm not a bass player. And so what we did is we sat down with bass players, all right? And a very particular, you know, progressive style player, guys that may play a little bit higher, the guys that have a lot more need for a two octave neck, want a different type of tonal variations with active EQs, and as well as like between ebony fingerboards, ash bodies or mahogany bodies, just a complete variable of that, and trying to keep it at a reasonable price. So these are DMT pickups with the active EQ, but then we're also dabbing with this, which is a combination of these two. So it's like the neck from the walnut with the body from the poplar. We're adding in the Fishman Fluence pickup. Now these just came out, and one of the things, it's like, well, it looks very simple, but it's really not, because this Fluence has three modes. So you have three entirely different pickup sounds in one pickup. And it's obviously adjustable by the low and the mid right here. And then obviously your volume. But you have a vintage sound, like a vintage 70s rock sound. You have a funky type tight slappy sound. And then you can get like that really tight metal sound out of it. So it's really just anything you want. And it's really compact. So we're really trying to push out something new here and experiment with some fun stuff.
This is really excellent because, you know, I'm not really much of a bass player myself. Like, you know, I play a little bit on mainly six string electric for me. Mm-hmm. But, and hanging with some bass players you know, in recent years, some serious players, you can tell that that's where they feel a bit shafted, that it's like, oh yeah, I don't want to just be like some sub thing to the guitar.
Right.
It's its own thing that needs specific tone woods and a specific right. look, and it looks like you've really catered to that. It's not just you've whacked on you know, some thicker strings and yeah. and that's it. You know, you're customizing it for
right.
them.
And this is no disrespect towards anybody out there in the bass market, but sometimes you want to make a bass that is geared for the really versatile bass player, not really just for the crappy guitar player that got the gig in his brother's band playing bass.
Sure.
I know that's a joke, no disrespect to the crappy bass player or a crappy guitar players that are playing bass, that's a joke.
Yeah.
But for the straightforward rock and roll guys that want the big sound pocket, you know,
yeah.
whether it be for the, you know, the finger playing or with the pick, we brought back the Hillsboroughs.
Okay.
So this has more of that, you know, instead of the 2-octave neck, back to the 22 frets, very, you know, just loud, brutal, big DMT pickups with the active EQs, but with the all ash bodies, swamp ash bodies with an open pore finish. There's no gloss, anything on it. Just basically open white, let the grain set. It's very crude and rough. And this is for, you know, that straight guy, whether you want to be that straightforward guy, that's whether you want to play music like the Ramones, whether you want to play music like Metallica, whatever it happens
yeah.
to be.
Yep, yep.
That's for you.
That's killer.
One more expansion in the world of basses, and that we wanted to have, not everybody plays six-string bass, and not everybody wants to drop a grand on a six-string bass either. So we wanted to have basically an X-series bass that dabbles in six-string, but that actually sounds good. All right, so it took some time. We had our factory create these six-string pickups for us, and it was one of those things that was almost a happy accident. They actually didn't make them right the first time, and we put them in. I'm like, don't change it. This is perfect.
Okay.
And it's just such a great value. When we were doing videos for them, we had Jesse over in Setupline do some playing videos for us. We were all kind of like, damn, that thing sounds really damn good for
yeah,
$269
yeah,
bucks.
Sure.
So I was like, all right, let's go.
That's the one.
So if you don't mind, I'd like to show you a couple of things with our signature stuff. Two of the things that we did is I wanted, and as a family, we wanted to bring in a couple more classic dime pieces, but at a professional level.
Okay.
So the Dimouflage, we've had that out before in the past, but it was at a, you know, in an X series price point type thing, and we wanted to bring something a little bit more exactly like, well, not exactly, but a lot more like his real one that he played.
Mm.
So we have this one with the set neck design, the one that are the, you know, the Floyd special on here, the right pickups, the better graphic, and, you know, it's a $750 price point, which is still at a great price for this whole line here.
Absolutely.
And that's like a real dime, what everybody's known for buying with dime. But then we all remember the Razorback Lightning,
yeah.
which was also in like an X series price point. We said, no, let's make that the real deal.
Fantastic.
So let's get that up there, and it's, you know, it's $11.99, but it's the true set neck design with the 1000 series Floyd, his pickups in it, everything down to the two grabber knobs and the one standard. Just take it right over the top, make a high end guitar.
Has that ever been available?
Nope, never.
That's fantastic news.
Never have. So we decided to finally do it now, and this is just kind of touching on what we're going to do with Dime. It's the same thing with the rest of the brand. Get more out of what's really, like, genuine to him.
Yeah.
You know, really genuine in what he's doing.
Because that is great news, because that's the thing for fans of Pantera and our just, you know, mm-hmm. great guitars in general. That's always been the thing that, yeah, there's always a dime range,
mm-hmm.
but people have wanted, like, the real deal, and it's like, oh, they haven't done that for X amount of years, so it's fantastic to know that
yeah.
it's actually coming out, and if you want to get that real deal thing, it's available for you, you know?
Yep, and it's only the beginning.
Mm.
We're going to make sure we bring everything up in a higher level.
Fantastic.
And it's not just for the sake of trying to make it expensive.
Yeah.
We just want it to be a lot closer to his actual product. So
yep.
we're going to be doing a lot more in USA that way, too.
Fantastic.
And, of course, the most talked about thing that we've had, the Kerry King. And the Kerry King V here, obviously, the lineage of what people don't know is that a lot of the pictures of Kerry King back in the first days of Slayer, he was playing an ML. And there's a lot of photos in 81 of him playing a black ML.
Interesting.
Him and Jeff, you know, the late Jeff Hanneman. So he's always had an affinity for Dean guitars.
Mm.
And as things progressed and as things happened, there's a lot of questions that I can't answer. It's not my place to, but I'm sure Kerry will when he comes here tomorrow. And but why us?
Yeah.
And it's something that his mindset, the way he is as a person, his personality, fits right in with our hoodlum asses. You know, we're not exactly the nicest kids on the block, and we're not, you know, we don't claim to be either. But we went over the top with this guitar, with the neck through design. The inverted cross inlays are actually ebony with the red stone nails and all wrapped in pearl. All hand done by Dan. And with the Sustainiac pickup, the Kerry King signature Kaler, but then also to top it off, and since there's only 50 of these made, they come with the LED side dots. That's and just to nice show touch. You how good these things are, is that we've had these LED side dots on now for 36 straight hours, and they're not burnt out yet. Or not burnt out, but they haven't lost a battery charge yet. Just to show a point. It's all fiber optic. It's really cool. They're very limited because these are exactly what he's using.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. This looks like a serious instrument.
This is only the beginning. We're going to be doing a lot with Kerry's models. We're going to make these things available in multiple price points. This is just the launch. This is the hey, we're here.
Yeah, man. It's exciting. Really exciting. That is quite an instrument.
Thank you. And but really, I mean, it's really Evan, Kerry, Josh, that team. Really just works,
yeah.
And the personalities just work, and that's why we're so excited, because it's only the beginning of it all.
It's going to be
a lot more to him.
For sure, in terms of the electronics that are going on there, obviously you've just gone through the pickups and stuff, but in terms of the switching options,
yes.
Where does this come about?
So what we have is the Sustainiac, so and that's one of them, and then you have the modes of that. You obviously have the three-way switching, but then you have the booster. So it has a lead boost built in, and that's the Kerry King mid-range boost from EMG, so that's okay. In there as well. Okay. So it has just options for days, and this is what he uses. It's like buying it off of his boat.
Yeah, nice one.
And there's only 50, but even when we make productions, they're going to be to his specs.
So he was road testing these then for a while, yeah?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. And the last few Slayer shows... there's pictures of them all over the place playing them.
For sure, no, there's been a lot of buzz about it, but I'm always quite fascinated by the whole road test thing, because it's like, how long could it, you might get one that's perfect, or it might take you years to get it right. What about this in particular? Do you know how long the whole process took?
The whole process, I would say, it's been probably pretty close to a year.
Right, okay.
Not quite, but pretty close. And it took Kerry coming down with Dan in the wood shop, really dialing in that neck shape, really dialing in the heel joint and how it felt, and the weight, the balance. This wasn't just a, hey man, let's just draw a pointy shape and we'll cut it out and paint it for you. Kerry was very particular.
Yeah.
And I don't think a lot of, I know everybody loves all the writing that he's done for the world, but the guy really has an uncanny knack of how his guitars feel. And we're not going to lie, first ones didn't work. Not that they were bad, they just weren't to his feel. So it took a lot of work to get it dialed in.
That's good to know.
Change of pace. Luna. Luna is our brand. We created it here 15 years ago. And one of the special things about Luna is that it has its own lifestyle. And when it first started, it was really about girls. It was really a feminine driven product. But as it developed and grew, and the last 2 years since I've been here, I've seen such a dramatic growth between men, women, and all different styles of life, just playing on all these different styles of instruments, because it really is a beautiful acoustic brand that is unbelievably affordable. And within just a short period of time, we're number two in the ukulele business in the world. And we're growing faster than we can ever imagine. And it's because of certain little things. And I can go through, we have a lot of SKUs, but I'm not going to go through everything.
Sure.
But I'm going to give you what the vibe is about.
Yeah.
Laser etching. Like I said, you have your aggression over there. You have your rock and roll, your metal, your sweat, your middle fingers. And over here, this is kind of like, hiking and being outdoors and relaxing and nature and
heading to the beach.
That's right, heading to the beach. All laser etched pieces, wonderful woods, even stuff like that.
Yeah, that's nice.
And really, like this over here, these exotic mahoganies are just so stunning for a ukulele. I mean, we really wanted to make it our own. Happy being in our own skin. We're not trying to look like another brand.
Sure.
We just decided to take off with it, and it all started from basically trying to make acoustic instruments that were art for people that like art.
That's it. This is something that you could definitely have in your living room, couldn't you?
Yeah.
You know.
And it moves around quite a bit too. So we have like exotic mahoganies and koas in the acoustic world for $449 with exotic tops like that.
Yep.
It takes a lot of time for the team to really get this thing dialed into where it can be an affordable instrument that looks beautiful.
Sure.
Ukuleles now are all in, the whole families are now together. So we have the concert, the soprano and the tenor, the baritones, resonators. Mm. You know, we had the Vista guitars out for a long time, and now we have the Vista ukes.
Wow.
And that's, these are all multi-layered, pieces. This is all inlay. This is, not a stick-on graphic.
Yeah.
And to have these really cool ukuleles and guitars with this kind of aesthetic, it just shows that it's really about acoustic and art. Brand new inlaid owl.
Yeah.
All in there.
Yeah, these are beautiful.
Just so nice, It's like, and it's the one thing, like even in my house, what I like to use my daughter as a reference, she's 11, and she loves ukulele.
Okay.
And even her dad being in a death metal band, it's not cool. She wants to be her own person.
That's it.
And, with her friends, they listen to music like this. Mm. And I encourage it all day long because she's her own person. She dresses her own style. She's not doing what what we tell her to do. But she fell in love with Luna. I was here for a year and a half. And she's like, Dad, have you ever heard of Luna? I'm like, I make it. She's like, that's my favorite. I want Luna, And she was all excited. I'm like, hey, it works.
Yeah.
Even even appease your kids somehow. Or
well,
not.
There you go. You've definitely had a miracle there.
One of the things that's really important with Luna right here, this is for me in the acoustic guitar world, the faunas and the floras. These kind of went away for a while. And now we have the factories building them again, better than ever. And they're a higher quality than they've ever been. But look at this inlay of the phoenix or the dragon and then the floral stuff. You can really tell, and I hate to be repetitious, but it really is a brand of art.
Yeah. There's no shortage of exotic woods you guys have been using on this. So how does it work with the CITES and what have you? Any problems there?
No. Fortunately, with CITES and everything else, it's now starting to work in our favor.
Okay.
It took a lot of time, but everything we do, obviously, is within, fish and game regulation. Everything is approved. We don't do anything shady that we'll talk about on camera. but literally everything is just, worked out with the factories, with game and fish and, across the ponds and regulations.
Yeah.
Rosewood is becoming much more, it's no longer being held back to the musical instruments companies. Musical instruments companies have been recognized as not really as much of a threat to the industry of wood, so to speak. We're not the rapers of the stuff. We're actually, when we make stuff at factories, we use it very economically. We don't waste. And, a lot of companies that cause those issues with CITES are the ones that are paying the price. And we actually had to pay the price for a long time, as well as all of our competition. And now we're just fine.
Yeah. Well, that's great news, especially in the UK, where we tend to sometimes be the last to get our hands on it for those reasons.
Mm-hmm.
So that's good to know that the guys can get their hands on all these fantastic instruments.
Yeah. And you can even take a look over there. See, like those laser etched Lunas.
Fantastic.
Like a Polynesian style tattoo. Look at the woods on those things, the spalts. We're just happy, and it's just such a great brand. And who'd ever think that in 15 years, the Luna brand is the same size as Dean.
Is it really?
Yep.
That's
it
amazing.
Is just a powerhouse, and we're growing so fast with it. I'm proud to be, a part of this.
Yeah.
But there you have it for the line. I just want to really be excited about where we are, telling the story of how things have been. And this is only the beginning.
Yeah.
We're expanding things out more and more. We're not going to over-skew it, but we now understand life cycle management a lot better. We understand SKU rationalization. That's the business side. But all of us now, never been more tight and more like in arms together to take this stuff on.
Yeah.
And like I said it before 1,000 times, we're proud to be in our own skin.
Yeah, well, Chris, look, thanks so much for having us here.
Thank you.
But before we do go, what's going on with you and your band? What's coming up in 2020?
2020. So we just finished the Mexico Metal Fest a couple of days ago, which was phenomenal. One of the best times I've ever had. Actually, I've been so lucky since I've been in the band that we have had so many great festival experiences. The hype has been bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. You know, for a band that's been around so long and a band that I was a fan of growing up and to be in the band, it's exciting. New music is coming. We're working on new music together. Right. Obviously, Steve has got just riffs galore ready to work on. And, you know, he's a fantastic guitar player as well as one of the most brutal and relentless drummers of all time. He's an amazing musician.
Yeah.
Him and Glenn work so well, and I can see why they've been a band together for 30 years. I'm just honored to be a part of it with them and a part of the writing process. So after we're doing that, we have South America for about a month in April. We got a lot of European festivals booked up. And Sweden, Finland, a lot more to be announced here soon, and then an American tour later in the year. Okay. All this while trying to put an album together at the same point. So sure. It's exciting, man. And, you know, he'll be down. Glenn and Steve will be down here tomorrow.
Great.
And I believe Kevin will be down here, too. So all four of us will be hanging out again because we actually, for the record, one of the few bands that I know that really all like each other and like hanging out with each other. So it's like when we're hanging out, even if we're not rehearsing, we're like, what can we do to all meet up somewhere? You know, it's like we enjoy it.
That's it. Well, meeting up at the Dean Factory, that sounds like a good time to me.
Yeah.
We're going to go and have a good time and pick up a cocktail. But look, thanks so much.
Thank you, man. I appreciate it, brother.